Peace be with you, and welcome to the Redemptorist Online Triduum, 3 days of prayer and reflection to our Mother of Perpetual Help. As disciples of St. Alphonsus, the Redemptorists bring Christ into the world by preaching the good news to the most abandoned. And at the center of our missionary activity, we bear the icon of Mary, our Mother of Perpetual Help, as a means of quenching many people's thirst for God. This icon of our Mother of Perpetual Help is a letter written not with ink, but with the Spirit of the living God. She's a letter for all of us, whether we are learned or not, saying to each one who prays before her what the Apostle Paul said to his followers in Corinth: "Be imitators of me as I am of Christ." And so may our prayer over these days steep us in that love for Mary, our Mother of Perpetual Help, and move us to share her with one another and the whole world. So please join now in singing our opening hymn, "Loving Mother, Most Merciful."
Loving Mother, most merciful, in you we see heaven's face. Loving Mother, most merciful, O image of God's love and grace. O image of God's love and grace. O Mary, blessed are you who bore the child. His hands you held with tender mother's care. May we embrace the child as you have shown, and know the touch of mercy, God's mercy and love. Loving Mother, most merciful, in you we see heaven's face. Loving Mother, most merciful, O image of God's love and grace, O image of God's love and grace. O Mary, in your heart you heard the Lord, the greatest mystery treasured deep within. Bring us into your stillness and your prayer to marvel at God's mercy. God's mercy and love. Loving Mother, most merciful, in you we see heaven's face. Loving Mother, most merciful, O image of God's love and grace, O image of God's love and grace. O Mary, gentle mother to the Son, in praise you lifted up your soul to God. So may we say with you, let it be done, let it be done in mercy, God's mercy and love. Loving Mother, most merciful, In you we see heaven's face. Loving Mother, most merciful, O image of God's love and grace. O image of God's love.
My name is Father Matt Allman, and the theme of my reflection today on this first day of our Triduum is the icon of love, a story. Please join me in the following prayer to Mary, our Mother of Perpetual Help. O Mary, Mother of Jesus and our Mother of Perpetual Help, great sign of our hope, we invoke your name. Help us who desire to be renewed during these 3 days of prayer and reflection. You have both the power and the goodness to help us in every need and circumstance of life. This moment is yours. Come then and help us. Be for us our refuge and our hope. Amen. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. During those days, Mary set out and traveled to the hill country in haste to a town of Judah, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the infant leapt in her womb, and Elizabeth, filled with the Holy Spirit, cried out in a loud voice and said, "Most blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And how does this happen to me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For at the moment the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the infant in my womb leapt for joy. Blessed are you who believed that what was spoken to you by the Lord would be fulfilled." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. In the story of the Visitation, Saint Elizabeth cries out with joy and wonder over the fact that the mother of her Lord has come to her. "How does this happen to me?" she says. It's almost too good to be true. And yet, true it is. St. Elizabeth's cry could be that of the Redemptorist when we reflect on the gift that the icon of our Mother of Perpetual Help has been to our congregation. How is it that the Mother of our Lord has come to us? As we begin this Triduum of celebration together in honor of the feast of our Mother of Perpetual Help, I'm going to use today to set the stage for the celebration, to give a little bit of context for the reflections that are to come in our next few days. And to do that, I need to tell you a story. Once upon a time, or actually 155 years ago, the icon of Our Lady of Perpetual Help was little known and largely forgotten. The icon was originally painted in Crete many centuries ago, and then a little over 500 years ago, it made its way to Rome and ended up hanging in the church of St. Matthew the Apostle in the city there. It hung in St. Matthew's for about 300 years. And there at St. Matthew's, it attracted a great number of local devotees, but it never really captured the worldwide attention of the faithful. Then at the turn of the 19th century, during a moment of chaos and upheaval, the Church of St. Matthew's was destroyed, and the icon was carried away for safety. She was taken by her custodians, the Augustinian friars, but in her new home, in their church across town in Rome, she became largely forgotten. Then the Redemptorist showed up. We came to Rome carrying with us a deep devotion to Mary and a lively tradition of preaching about Mary's great maternal love and her powerful intercession. The Redemptorist passion for Mary was instilled in us by our founder, St. Alphonsus Liguori. St. Alphonsus was a great lover of Our Lady, and he never missed an opportunity to talk about her, to write about her, even to compose music and sing about her and her glories. Before Mary's Immaculate Conception was defined as a doctrine of the Church, St. Alphonsus Liguori already had the Redemptorists swear that we would defend the truth of this teaching. And when St. Alphonsus was writing the original rule for the Redemptorists, he had it included there that in every Redemptorist retreat or parish mission, there had to be at least one talk completely devoted to Mary. St. Alphonsus insisted that his brothers cultivate a devotion to Our Lady, something like his, but it was not to be a devotion just for our own hearts or for our own benefit. You see, St. Alphonsus didn't love Mary just for herself or just for himself. It was also his experience as a missionary in his day that there was nothing more effective for calling out the most hardened sinners and bringing them to repentance than to introduce them to the maternal love and the powerful intercession of their mother, Mary. Up until the Redemptorist's arrival in Rome in the middle of the 19th century, our congregation didn't have any particular image of Mary or title for Mary that we used to use more than others. Mary was our patroness as the Immaculate Conception, but when we were preaching about her or promoting her devotion among others, we would really use any Marian imagery or title we happened to have around us. That all changed in 1865. A few years earlier, the Pope had asked the Redemptorist to move our headquarters from Naples to Rome. And when we made the move to Rome, without knowing what we were doing, we purchased a property known as the Villa Caserta, which happened to be the property where the old church of St. Matthew had stood. We set up our general house there on that property between the great Roman basilicas of St. Mary Major and St. John Lateran, right on the parade route for Corpus Christi, right where Mary herself had long ago, in a vision, said she wanted her icon to hang. Soon after our arrival in Rome, we began hearing stories of the miraculous icon that used to hang in a church on our property. And then we discovered that the icon of Our Lady of Perpetual Help was not in fact lost, but that it was still in Rome, but hanging without great ceremony in an Augustinian chapel across town. So we took action. We asked Pope Pius IX if our Mother of Perpetual Help could come home, if she could come back to the spot she herself had chosen years ago, and now to hang in the new church of St. Alphonsus Liguori, located on our property, still between the basilicas of St. Mary Major and St. John Lateran. Pope Pius IX was a great fan of St. Alphonsus and of the Redemptorists. So in 1865, he told the Augustinians to give us the original icon of Our Mother of Perpetual Help. They were given a copy in return. And then the Pope told us, Redemptorists, to make Our Lady of Perpetual Help known. Make her known, he said. And I don't know if there are any other papal commands that have ever been better obeyed than that one. In 1866, the Redemptorists revealed the icon to the world again with a great festival triduum at the new church of St. Alphonsus. Miracles accompanied the icon from that first celebration. In April of 1866, the Giornale di Roma, one of the Roman daily newspapers of the time, records the story of a woman whose child had been crippled from birth. She held her child up before the icon during its first procession into St. Alphonsus Church, and her child was restored to health immediately. After that, stories of healing associated with the icon came pouring in, especially as the Redemptorist had copies of the image made, pictures and medals and prints, you name it, and started bringing them with us on our missions all throughout the world. Our Lady of Perpetual Help became the face of the Redemptorist's Marian preaching, and her fame spread everywhere that we went, and then beyond, to the point that now the image of our Mother of Perpetual Help is the most reproduced image of Our Lady in the entire world, and you can find her pretty much anywhere you go. The truth is, though, that often when promoting Our Mother of Perpetual Help, popularizing her image and her title, the Redemptorist did it without giving much attention to the nature of the image itself. We Redemptorist missionaries tended to use Mary's image to tell the story of her comforting the child Jesus after a dream of his passion, and to preach about her maternal love and her powerful intercession. But we often neglected to attend to the deep gift that our mother had given us as an icon, not just as another pretty picture of Our Lady. We encouraged people to turn to Our Mother of Perpetual Help in prayer, but we often didn't appreciate for ourselves or show others how they could pray with Mary through her icon itself. You see, the image of Our Mother of Perpetual Help is an icon, and that's a form of sacred art particularly associated with our Eastern Christian churches. Icons are different from most Western religious art. Icons have their own language. They need to be approached in their own way. They're considered windows into heaven, into the sacred, into the holy. And they invite us to draw near, to approach them in prayer, and to see what they reveal and make present as we stand before them. Every bit of the icon, the colors, the characters, their positions, has something to say to us, and it can carry us more deeply into union with the holy ones that are represented therein. It's actually partly because of our deepening appreciation of this image of Our Lady as an icon that in the 1990s, when we undertook a restoration of the original icon with the help of the Vatican Museums, that we chose to remove the ornate golden crowns that the Vatican chapter had long ago affixed above Mary and Jesus as an honor, recognizing the image's miraculous history and the long devotion attached to it. The crowns were removed to better let the original image speak for itself as an icon. But you can still find them in many reproductions of the icon around the world, just like the one we have here in our house behind me, or you might have in your own home or in your parish church. I hope that this brief presentation has given you some sense of the story behind the Redemptorist association with the icon of Our Mother of Perpetual Help, and why we Redemptorists are so excited to share this Triduum and this celebration of her feast with you. Right? Like St. Elizabeth at the Visitation, we are filled with joy and wonder that the Mother of our Lord has come to us. We look forward to continuing our prayer and reflection with you in the days to come. And Father Jim Wallace will share with you tomorrow more specifically about what Our Mother of Perpetual Help can say to us as an icon today. Thank you.
Please join in singing this simple chant to Mary entitled Mary the Dawn. It is a beautiful meditation using analogies from Mary and Jesus, many of which come from the Old Testament.
Mary the Dawn, Christ the perfect day. Mary the Gate, Christ the heavenly way. Mary the Root, Christ the mystic vine. Mary the Grape, Christ the sacred wine. Mary the Wheat, Christ the living bread. Mary the Stem, Christ the rose blood red. Mary the Font, Christ the healing flood. Mary the Chalice, Christ the saving blood. Mary the Temple, Christ the temple's Lord. Mary the Shrine, Christ the God adored. Mary the Beacon, Christ the haven's rest. Mary the Mirror, Christ the vision blessed. Mary the Mother, Christ the Mother's Son. Both ever blessed, while endless ages run.
Let us pray together this beautiful prayer to the icon of love. O Mother of Perpetual Help, icon of love, your maternal gaze entrusts us to the love of the Father. Help us to make you known even more, and to be missionaries of the good, beautiful, and joyful life of the gospel. Open our hearts to the cry of those without hope, until all come to believe. Teach us to ponder the word in our heart and to do what your Son asks us to do. Enable us to walk with you with the great light of faith to light our path. And thus one day we will be able to contemplate with you the face of the Father who with the Son and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Thank you for joining us during these days of prayer and reflection to our Mother of Perpetual Help. This Saturday, June 27th, the feast day of Mary, our Mother of Perpetual Help, the Redemptorists here at Holy Redeemer will celebrate Mass on both Facebook and YouTube at 12 o'clock in the afternoon. We hope you can celebrate with us. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Through the intercession of Mary, our Mother of Perpetual Help, may Almighty God bless and keep you, protect and guide you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
It is the custom for Redemptorists at the conclusion of celebrations to sing the Salve Regina, an ancient Latin hymn that is the English prayer, Hail, Holy Queen. So please join with us in singing this lovely chant.
Salve.